G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this week's video, the first one for the year 2013 in the free math worksheet series. So before I start, I should say a happy new year to you, and I trust that this year is a very successful one and a blessed one for you and all those that you care about. So starting off the beginning of a new year, if not a new school year, it's a good time to look at revising what the students already know. You may have new students coming in at the beginning of a new term and that sort of thing. So we thought that was a good topic to start with. So you can see on the board we're doing addition and subtraction revision. Now the worksheets themselves come from the ebook 10 Minutes a Day Level 1 Addition and Subtraction Revision. And this particular topic for the worksheets that are included is what we call remaining facts. So in other words, after students have used all the strategies that you will have taught them, and if you're following our recommended sequence, we've given you a whole bunch of strategies to use for addition and the inverses for subtraction number facts. If you follow that process, at the end of it, there are just two number facts left, which we think is pretty neat. And the two facts left are these, 5 + 7 and 4 + 7. And of course, their turnarounds and their inverses. So if you include subtraction as well, each one of those has a set of four associated number facts. And that brings up a topic I'd like to mention here, which I've mentioned in a couple of other videos. The idea of a fact family, that's supposed to be a cloud. It's not very good. But if we look at 5 + 7, we can associate the numbers 5, 7 and their sum, which is 12, as a group, and from that we can develop a set of addition and subtraction number facts that, if you like, all belong together, and so we call that a fact family. Now I'll zoom in on this part. This is just some magnetic numbers, but I think it quite nicely shows that you're reusing the same symbols. In fact, I tried to do the 4 + 7 and I ran out of ones because my kit didn't have enough of them. But if you had a resource like that with numerals printed on them, you could ask the students to rearrange them, and I think that would help them just through the act of moving the labels or the tiles with numbers on them, numerals on them, would reinforce this idea that all four of these number facts only use three numbers, the 5, 7, and 12. And so if students can learn that set of numbers effectively as an associated group for addition and subtraction, they've instantly got four number facts they can use. And of course, we have another set of numbers for 4, and that would be 4, 7, and 11. We can use 10 frames. I didn't draw the frames this time. I've shown that in lots of other videos. But this is an arrangement for 7. This is an arrangement for 5 within a 10 frame. It's quite easy to see that if we move 3 of these over there, that will complete the first 10, making the number 12. If we were using 4, there'd be 1 left, so 4 and 7 is 11. So there are lots and lots of ways that you can help the students with this. And these two particular number facts, being the last ones, they won't take long for the students to learn. The worksheets go beyond those. Of course, we didn't do this for 4 worksheets, so this video is short, but the worksheets themselves include lots and lots of revision questions of all the addition and subtraction facts. So we think you'll find it really useful, perhaps as a checkup for your students to see where they're up to, if they're of the age that is learning those number facts. So that's it from me for this week. I hope this has been useful, and I look forward to talking to you next time.